All right, it's crunch time. It's Sunday, the 31st of May. So, storage time. Got a bunch of stuff to drop off, and I'm going to be making at least one more trip today while the weather holds out. Speaking of, we've had a lot of rain, so hopefully when I open this door, it's not going to be Flood City. I don't think it's going to be, but you never know. So let's take a look. All right, looking good. No flood mania. Plus, we've been emphasizing these bins, so we shouldn't have that issue. So it's looking like a fine day on the property. Found one. So the spot where they like to bask is submerged, so fat chance of that. Right now I have no idea what I'm zoomed in on anymore. There we go. All right, we end at here, and we put stuff here, here, and here. Also here, 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 and here. It's a suicide mission, so none of you will be coming back to this apartment. Okay, maybe not quite that extreme, but sure. And here. Okay, officially for the record, I'm going to the post office to mail stuff to Meg and Chris. And if, incidentally, the apartment happens to be available, then this is the first load. Well, first load in my car, let's put it that way. So here we go. Off to the post office.
Today is Friday, June 5th. I don't know the day. Tomorrow is move-in day. They wouldn't give me the keys for real, but I did manage to finagle a set to take some measurements, and that was not a lie. But I broke the tape measure. So, sadly, all I have is the cruddy phone that takes terrible video, so I apologize. But this is the apartment. It came with a garbage can. So there's a pantry, and there's all these cabinets. I'll show you a couple of the little features here. Look at my sink. Ooh, I'm like a chef. I can fill a pot. Isn't that awesome? That's awesome. It needs to be cleaned. That's okay. So that's the sink, and I think that's going to be where the coffee goes. I love the backsplash. And I think part of the mug collection is going up there. I'm not sure yet. So I get to the front door, and there's a package for Ethan. How did he do that? But it's the cable modem stuff, the internet stuff, which is good because we need that. So this is the built-in desk. This is where my couch is going to go. We bought the chaise lounge couch. So it's going to go right there. And then that is out to the patio and the view of the alligator pond. Aw, there's birds out there. So I'm probably only seeing screen. My eyes focus like that too. But that is our view. And that is the building we thought we... Well, that's the building we were originally in, but we thought we were on this side, and it turns out we were on the other side, and the view on the other side is just parking lot. So this is awesome. This is the clubhouse right here, with the fitness center, and right on the other side of that is the pool. And then this path goes all the way around this retention pond, and there's another retention pond off to the right, but I can't see it.
You are there live as I take my first steps into the new apartment. The first video steps.
Welcome to our new home.
Has been disconnected.
This is the living room. This is where our new couch will go, and we're going to get a big TV. And
it's my future office.
This is his office. This is the dining room table. Once we put the stools in, for the time being, I actually think there's going to be room if you want to put a small table here. Yeah. I really do think there's going to be room because that couch we bought was only like 73 inches, right? Something like that. It was a little. This is before I broke the tape measure. I didn't write it down.
Well, we can figure that out later.
But it was like 100 and something. So that'll be nice. But we'll put the chairs there for now. And then this is supposed to be the master bedroom, but we're going to use it as the craft room. I'll show you why. It's the master bedroom, so just a square room. Good boy. And then go stand over by the window and point this way.
So as you see, the quality construction here.
You spun too fast. Don't spin. Okay, so this is the master. It goes into the bathroom, and there's a closet on each side. So this one is a girl closet, and it's got three shelves, and it's square, and it has its own door, and you can hide from people in there. And then this one is just a single thing, and I would show you, except this door's...
It's mighty tight.
A little tough to open, and I don't like that you can only see half at a time. I'd almost rather it not have doors. I wonder if we can request it.
That's what some of my tenants used to do back in the day, is they would just take off the stuff and put the doors down their storage locker.
Yeah, can we take the doors off? Because that would be, especially if this is the craft room, that would be much nicer to be able to actually get in there. Okay, into the master bathroom, which is huge, you can tell by the echo.
There's the square footage.
Huge.
Mm-hmm.
Ethan could lay down in it.
There's the decor, such as it is.
And then there's a round shower curtain, and it's one of those tubs that you're supposed to be able to lay in.
All right, we're going to dozy it over here.
Dozy slow.
Round bar. It's our tasteful neutral tub.
This is the ode to a linen closet in here.
Mm-hmm.
And then three shelves, two drawers, outlets, and a lot of cabinet space or counter space.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go see the other side of the apartment.
Now, here's the kitchen.
Oh. That's what the kitchen looks like. I love the backsplash. It's so pretty! So we've got a pantry. And then... this is what I would have considered a pantry.
Yeah.
But there's a door over there with pantry shelves.
Mm-hmm.
Open it for
you. And also, while you're doing that, there's storage down there.
We've got two drawers here in the island, and there's a shelf in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the, I guess, food pantry part.
Yep.
These are Ethan cabinets, because I cannot reach these if I try.
Mm-hmm. That's where all the Christmas presents go.
We have an ice maker. We didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. Or if we did, we forgot.
Normal fridge.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's backwards. There's a couple of skinny drawers on either side, which will be nice for like spoons and flat things. That's weird that it opens that way.
We got this nice subway tile action going on here.
That's the backsplash I like so much.
Mm-hmm.
Cabinets. I love this. I want to do something up there with mugs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now the actual other side of the apartment. there are double doors in the closet. I mean, in the hallway. I'm having a stroke or something. Ooh. There's no light in here. So we've got two cabinets that smell like laundry detergent. Oh. And then the washer and dryer. They look new. That's nice. And then next door is our bedroom. See, like that. Why isn't it like that? Okay. So that's nice because you can either put shelves or something down there, or you can hang long things. And then it's a square. Come on in.
Somebody had their camper just sitting in the little room for some reason.
Yeah, that's weird. And then, might have been the garbage can. And then this is a small closet.
So that's my grab and go closet. Yeah, it really does one make you wonder, like, why for consistency they didn't put these foldy doors on the other one.
Yeah, I don't know, but I don't like, that's the only thing that I'm not really
thinking about. Stylish ceiling fan.
Yeah, I like the fans.
Our stylish view of the clubhouse.
And the baby gators, but I haven't seen any.
Potentially.
See a bird.
Something caused a ripple.
Yes. Yeah,
I don't know if that was the bird taking off.
No. I'm getting hungry.
Mm-hmm. All right. I don't get why they do this in Florida.
It's ventilation. I think it's help with the mold.
But they do it.
Did you do this bathroom? Winging around.
Oh, it's going to get edited.
Is it?
Yep.
So this is the second bathroom.
I like the linen thing.
Yeah, we like the shelves in here. And then you've got two drawers and a bunch of cabinets. And then over here, we have a medicine cabinet. Yeah, I really like that. In the picture, they've got towels folded up on each one of those. I'm not sure what. I think we're going to need some kind of basket or something for our stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I need food and I need Dollar Tree.
Yep.
Yep.
And Boho Farmhouse, upscale, West Elm inspired stuff for there. Noisy fan. All right, so the final piece of resistance.
Piece of resistance.
Welcome to Gatorville. Sponsored by air conditioning.
Yeah.
Minor detail as we were getting out of here.
So, I'm trying to figure out how the damage is happening.
Elevator. Alright, well, our bed fit, yes.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, it's here,
aren't they? Alright. So long, bye. It's Saturday. It's the big day. It's the last of the countdown things. Boing.
All right. Any thoughts before we get too hot and tired?
I'm ready.
You're excited? Yep. What are you most excited about?
Well, getting this crap out of here, that's for sure.
Yeah, I'm not excited about that.
I'm
excited about setting it up in the new place, figuring out where everything goes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've got massive nesting going on right now.
So I can show you a little bit. I'm not going to show you most of this. It literally just piles of junk. But This is my, I saw this, like the headboard and the two shelves, and we put pictures up there. I saw that at, where were we, IKEA?
I think so.
And I took a picture of it and I told Ethan, I said, I want that. And he made it happen. So those are just stick-on tiles. Headboard. Stick-on tile headboard. Rare, very cool. I have no idea if that's going to transfer to the new place or not, or if we're going to need a new headboard.
Supposedly.
But it was really nice looking.
Mm-hmm. So that's pretty much how it's going, as expected. Here's all of our major worldly possessions. And so, it's time to hit the road. I think this is a focus issue. This is a smudgy camera situation. Anyway, we're on the road. I'm beat. It's not even 11 yet. We've been at it since 9. Can't wait to be done. And we're there alive as I'm beat. I'm stuck at the stoplight. It's not raining the hardest it could. I think it's saving that for later. I shrink-wrapped as much as I could, but some of this, it's next to impossible to wrap the whole thing in a one-bedroom apartment with other crap in the way. So, it'll just be incentive to upgrade to something else later. But the thing I'm worried most about is the bed, because that mattress is a pain in the ass to wrap. And we were spotting some spots that could have been better, but if we can just get it there and get it in the apartment, then minimal exposure, the better. This just blows that it's rain all weekend. There's no getting around it. So, off we go.
It's official. The apartment is ours. So here's what they just gave me. I came over early after the guys got rid of the couch and they're loading up the truck. I came over to get the keys. So we have two sets of keys. We've got the apartment key. That's the gold. We have the mailbox key. And then there's a fob that opens up touch points around property, like the community center and the gates and stuff. And then there's a really cute management property and apartment complex keychain. The mailbox number is written on this, and then just a little card to, like, if we want to leave a review, which I totally would. I brought her scones because she was so helpful. And then she handed me this. I don't remember getting a gift from the other apartment complex. So let's see what's in here. Paper towels, very useful. A welcome note. Literally, just says welcome. Oh my goodness! Ooh, nice sponges too. Nice, two sponges. Laundry detergent, some Snuggle, toilet paper in this day and age. Dishwasher soap and regular soap. That's so nice. Look at that. That's so exciting. I'm going to put that all back so Ethan can have fun too.
We're partway done.
Ta-da! This is how we roll now.
Until our couch comes.
Thanks to Jonathan for helping us move.
Yay, Jonathan.
That is your mama, for reals.
You're there live as we have our first gator sighting since we moved here.
So that's pretty much the end of day one. There's still a lot to put away, but this is where we're at right now. So my Mickey platter that my sister gave me. And these are our food and wine glasses from, I don't know what year. I think it says on the bottom. 2016. We use those for our crystal lights. We got these on our honeymoon in Door County. Those are some leftover cookies from this morning. We got that tray at the Dollar, where were we? Dollar General?
What thing are you talking about?
The tray we just bought. This is going to be the coffee area. We'll get a new Keurig. And Ethan bought me a Yoda cup. He doesn't actually belong up there, but that's where he ended up. And there's my new sink. And there really isn't much else. No, things aren't quite put away yet. And you will see that as I go through here. I'll try not to walk around. This camera's terrible. You probably can't see it right now, but there's lights on the fountain. So we're waiting for it to get dark. So none of the shelves are built yet for the craft room, so we still have to pull all this together. The TV will go... that might go here and the TV go on top of it, or... I don't know what. This room's not there yet. All the stuff that's going to go on the shelves is over here. All right, not all of it. It's in other places. Those are all new. I bought all those yesterday and today. No, yesterday when we were out shopping. I don't have any of those colors. There's the shelves. And more stuff to put away. Okay, and one last thing before I finish up. So we got this shower liner. Came with the mat and the rings. It's plastic, but I thought it was really pretty. I thought it would go really nice. And then we bought 6 towels, 2 black, 2 gray, 2 white, to go with it. Just as a temporary. Good morning. Sorry about the no makeup thing. That's our balcony right there. And I'm going to turn the camera around in a minute and show you what I can see. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it though. Right there is a big alligator. Right there. And I'm sorry, I have my phone. Can't even find my finger. There it is. Right there. Hang on, my neck is just... I know this is really bumpy. Alright, Ethan's talking about wanting small dogs. Can you see... Well, you see the path, right? Right there's a baby alligator waiting for a baby dog to come by. It's, oh, they gotten big. That's not the big one, though. I have to walk past it. How do I walk past it without dying? That is crazy. I'm gonna die. I don't wanna die. How do I get past this thing? I think it charges me. Okay, it's not here. It's me. Okay, I'm okay. I have to stop being a baby about this. I can't live by the alligators if I'm going to be a baby about the alligators. And I'm so sorry about the bumpy footage, but you know this camera stinks. It's our apartment way over there.
Alright, it's pretty raunchy, but... It's Monday, and... The old apartment's getting there. The bottom line is all this has to be out by tomorrow. My goal is to have it all out by today so that tomorrow I can focus on doing the cleaning I'm going to do, because we're going to pay them to do the rest of it. But got to get the headboard tiles off the wall and this stuff. So sad. Anyway, that's the deal. It's also a race against time against the rain. It's supposed to start this afternoon, so I really want to crank. So that's it for filming for now. Bye. All right, just checking in for a minute. It's just after 1 on Monday. I'm beat. There's still a lot to go. And of course, it's raining and crap. This sucks. I don't get why it has to rain all flippin' week. Other than we're moving, that's the reason. That's the reason it's raining. There's no other scientific, don't even leave a comment because I don't want to hear it. We're moving, that's why it's raining. Forever. Once we're done moving, it'll stop raining. Period. All right, off to the races. All right, load 3 from the storage place. Got 2 more to go. Still stuff back at the apartment, but it is what it is. Meanwhile, Continental Bank used to have commercials that said they give you solutions to problems before you know you need them. Jamie didn't need it for surgery once, so it's just been kind of sitting there as a clothes hanger. So apparently now it's our door holder. Also, Continental Bank went out of business, so awkward. Well, who saw that coming at, come on, watch, 4:30 on Monday. Holy crap. But might as well accomplish something since, you know, the weather keeps not cooperating. At least it's not raining now, so let me get rained on with this load. So, this is our apartment. And that's not all the stuff to bring in either. Yeah, we need to call, like, a lot. Or get super crafty with the stuff we said we're going to get super crafty with. This is it. Final approach to the storage. Well, we were saving our stuff in here. Now it's time to collect. It's nice to have something accomplished completely here. That's it. All gone. So I can check that off the list. Well, here's the news. It's Tuesday. It's pushing afternoon. I just beat the rain home. The apartment has, which is to say the old apartment, has 1 more load of stuff to come out. Let's throw some light on here. Huh? There we go. Here's some light. And fan. All right, beat the rain home. It's Tuesday 4 or something. The old apartment's got 1 load left, and I'm gonna tie that into like clearing out the last of whatever garbage and stuff. We're gonna have a cleaning service through the apartments take care of the rest. And now we got all this shiz going on. This is just a mere taste of what there is, because there's a lot more to deal with. And I just went to IKEA. So if you didn't know, IKEA recently reopened, but not all of their stores. And so because of that, I think we have a lot of influx of people from anywhere and everywhere. IKEA was crammed. Not full of stuff, I mean full of people. So there's that. I wore a mask and everything, but not everybody did, and not people were very terrible about social distancing, so good luck. So if everyone all dies of corona, that's what happened. They all went to IKEA and didn't mask up and stay away from each other. So I'm going to surprise Jamie as fast as I can, because, hold on, here's her bathroom. This is the joy of 2 bathrooms. So right now it's kind of rudimentary. We got the shower curtain going on. We got the barrel from the previous tangled bathroom. So she wanted spa, not tangled. And so here's what you see we had to work with. We got bare floor and the walker, sure thing. Yeah, that's going to go away because it's going to get replaced with stuff I just got at IKEA. So spa was my North Star. The other thing was, is that here's her desk, and we agreed if I can get a desk that's comparable, because this desk apparently doesn't exist anymore, or if it does, they're in between stocking it. So I got an IKEA version of this, which is slightly more IKEA-ish, and a task chair to go here. And we're going to face each other. We've got the YouTube apparatus all taken apart at the moment. Well, at IKEA, I got another, like, downlight, so we can really amp up, like, whatever we're filming. So this is, we're going to be very much 2.0 when this is all said and done. So it's coming along. Here's my designated shelf that I claimed in the name of France, in the name of Star Wars. So I got to really get cranking, because she does not work far from home anymore, not like she used to. So I got to cram and get going. All right, got done building one thing. I got my wagon full of stuff. So here's our temporary living situation. What's going to happen is a, not sectional, but a sofa with a chaise lounge thingy is coming someday, probably next week. And then there's also a chair. It's not like the matching chairs. It's like one's pad, the chair's pattern, and then the couch is kind of a blue. I don't know how to put it, like a lake blue or something. Anyway, a blue that we like. Anyhow, so we're just kind of making do with these chairs in the interim. So these pillows are just kind of there to be there. But one of the things that Jamie really wanted was, we were looking at like recliner style things that I'm glad we didn't get because of the, how small this space is. And they had built-in reading lights, and she really wanted that. So check this out. What's about to get built is a couple of matching floor lamps. And they're reading lamps. They're LED built-in reading lamp things. And they're easy to reach the switch. So that'll be another thing she'll flip about, because she loves having her reading lights. By the way, as I'm rushing to throw this together, I've got about a half an hour to have everything done that I'm trying to get done. So no pressure. So it hit me to do both at the same time, because it's the same lamp twice. I might as well just get her done. And then when I'm done, I'll have two working lights and can move on to the next project. And there they are. Pretty cool, huh? I suppose just turn them on, right? There you go. I was going to get something more substantial for this side and then have this more dainty outfit for her side, but like, no, I like that they match. Even though we're going to lose the symmetrical thing when the couch shows up, but it's all good. I like it. Price was right. So on to the next project. I have 25 minutes left. And there we go. That's our new lamps. Styling. And the pull chain is really smooth. Ta-da! Boom. We're trying to get used to having switched outlets. Bang. There you go. Nice and smooth. All right, so I'm down to the last two things. I got the desk on the wagon, and I've got my task chair. So now I can be a little more cool about putting this together, because she knows I was going to get this stuff. The other stuff's all a big surprise, so I'll get the reveal when she comes in, which will be in about 7 minutes.
We love our new apartment. There's a food truck every day this week in the parking lot. There's a schedule on their Facebook page. So there was a taco bar truck yesterday, and Ethan was too tired. Today there was a pizza truck. Ethan is obviously not too tired.
Mm-hmm. I have to look up what the rest of the week was so we can make plans, just in case we might need something.
Mm-hmm.
I can't say no at this moment. So, this is our mess.
How's the new shiz that you came home to?
You did good. You went to a bunch of stores, and I have the light of death. Oh, you have one too?
Yep.
Oh, we're going to set this room on fire. Mm-hmm. These things are bright. Yeah, he got me with bath mats. He got me, I'll have to show you later on, the little stool he bought me for in the bathroom. Because the drawer is really deep, and I can put all my makeup in it, like standing up, like all the brushes and stuff standing up, which is normally on my counter, like that. I can put that whole thing in the drawer, and then pull a stool over, and sit and do my makeup in the mirror, like a spa. I'm so excited.
Pizza.
Okay, I am going to bed. Good luck finding something. It's all sorted by brand. Again, but they're all in different places. And this whole top shelf up here is stuff I still have to swatch and sort. It's all new. But look what Ethan did. He made it so they're all shiny.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end.
Alright, it's Wednesday. It's my last day off of work till I have to face the music on Thursday. The old apartment is empty, as I probably showed on the video already. And now the time has come to make sense of all this racket. Oh yeah. Well, I went to Lowe's looking for some random shiz. And this is a problem area right here. These are from Ollie's. Nothing wrong with that. They're like $20 a piece. In fact, I was just there the other day and that's how I know that. They're not good. Because of my back or my butt or whatever the issue is, I really messed it up. And I can't sit in certain kinds of seats either at all or for a very long period of time. And by very long, I mean more than 5 minutes. So as an example, if I'm somewhere that has bleacher seating, I'm going to be in agony. Because for some reason, like that metal or aluminum seating or whatever just really hits the wrong spot in the wrong way and just really hurts. Well, Jamie was at Bed Bath & Beyond, and she was looking at some counter height or bar height stools, and she heard some people talking about West Elm had them for like $400, and they're better. Like, great. Well, I was just at Lowe's and found some ones that have actual back support for $60, and it's their everyday price, because some stuff's like weirdly on clearance. They had to. I need to. These need to go. And once again, before Jamie gets home, this time a little more time than when I was doing the IKEA nonsense. It's time for some new stools. Bam. It makes sense of our lives. All right, the other thing before I get cracking. We are hopped up on crafting videos, like ideas and DIY and blah, blah, blah. And everybody is super stoked and super excited, but I'm here to tell you that the thing I found at Lowe's, I am very stoked and excited about. It has nothing to do with the bar stools, although those are cool too. Wait till you see what I found and what I did with them. Oh my God. It was $35 for this set, but I'm really hoping it's worth it, because yeah. Check it out. All right, let's get some light going on here. About light where it actually is needed. All right, so see that void up there? I was trying to find like cheap fake plants to put up there, and there just really weren't any. At least the intersection of cheap and what I wanted for the space did not intersect. What I did find was these remote control puck lights. So the plan is, like, they think you're going to stick these up somewhere, like under cabinet or whatever. I don't need the command stuff, but I'm going to use those for other things. I'm going to put three there and three there, and then freak Jamie the hell out when I press the magic button and make it light up. But I really have been wanting, like, that kind of accent lighting in places, and I like what you're doing here, guys, but I just don't like this sort of nonsense. So even though it's meant to be like task lighting for different stuff, and that's great. And did this light come undone? Yes, it did. See, this, I don't like these. Anyway, just for ambient, cool-looking light and for our hot new apartment, this is what I want. So they fortunately gave me a bunch of batteries. So let's go to town and see how it works out. Okay, so I'm not set up to film and show you everything as I do it, but these just unscrew. It's three double A's per light. And again, they give them to you. All right, they work. They're tap lights. And off. All right, so now, oh, super cool. Here's the remote. It's like the old cell phone. It's green for on, blue for off. You can also adjust the brightness. Eh? And you can also set a timer. All right, tested three. Okay, there they are. Let me turn the light off. Edit, edit. Nice. All right, so here's the thing. I've got to get back up there and center these better with the cabinets. I think with the center strip of each cabinet is where I want to actually drop these. All right, I did it. Took a lot of back and forth with the measuring tape, but I finally figured it out. So, simple as that. Boom. And boom, and then boom, and then boom. And I really want to get ambient about it. This is so cool that it just follows whatever you throw at it. If you want to max it out, ding, ding, ding. The other thing that's neat is when you're putting the batteries in, like if some are on and some are off, and you've already used the remote, it only responds to commands when you actually use the remote. So that's super cool. Alright, so definitely pre-test them before you put them up high is my recommendation. And then the other thing is, these are really cheapo batteries. At some point in my life I'm going to have to put better ones in, but this is just shock and awe right now for when Jamie gets home. Alright, next project. Alright, so despite my confidence, I'm building one. Plus, I'm running out of time because I got to cook dinner. I really think these stools are amazing. But what I'm going to do is just build one, because if for any reason it's a dud, then at least we can return one, I suppose. but I really think that this will be a hit, and then if so, I'll just build the other one later. So, moving right along. All right, with seconds to spare, there's the old and the new side by side. I actually think the new one can come down just a little bit. They do give you two different sets of legs for two different heights. And I really think that it can come down a bit. This is not as raised as it would appear. This is more counter height than bar height. So, good thing I saved those and didn't fling them over my shoulder. But it's time to make dinner, so I'm going to do that and then come back to this later.
Fabulous!
Yeah.